A very good morning to my dear students. So today we are going to begin with chapter number 11, Ratio and Proportion. So this topic we are going to include in algebra subject. So now let's begin with the lesson. So before starting the lesson, just take your maths textbook and open page number 56 and refer the textbook while I am teaching the lesson. So now let's learn how to compare two numbers. So last year we have studied one way and this year we are going to study another way. So now I have taken an example, and in this example we are having two students whose names are Ramesh and Nilima, and both of their ages are given in this example. So Ramesh is 6 years old and Nilima is 12 years old. So now we have to compare their ages. So I'll ask question to Ramesh. Okay, so the question is, how will you compare your ages? Ramesh found the answer. Yes, he found the answer by finding out the difference, means by subtracting. Okay, so he took the two numbers, that is Nilima's age and his age, that is 12 minus 6 is equals to 6. So what is the answer what he got? Yes, the answer what Ramesh got is 6, and he has used last year's way to find out the difference or to compare their ages. So he gave the answer, Nilima Tai is elder to me by 6 years. Okay, means she is elder and he is younger. Yeah, that is Nilima Tai is 6 years elder than him and he is 6 years younger than her. Okay, so he used last year method and found out the answer. Now I'll ask another question to Nilima. There is also another way of comparing numbers, no? So now I'll ask Nilima. So I'll ask the question to Nilima, that is, can you tell how many times your age is more than Ramesh? So she did division of their ages. Okay, because I asked her how many times, isn't it? So she did division and got the answer. Now let's see how she divided. So she divided her age with Ramesh age. How much, what is her age? Yes, her age is 12 and Ramesh age is 6. So she did 12 divided by 6. So these two numbers are coming in 2's table, isn't it? So she divided both the numbers by 2. So 12 divided by 2, 6. 6 divided by 2, 3. Now 6 and 3 are again coming in 3's table. So she divided 6 divided by 3 and 3 divided by 3. So answer is 2 upon 1. Yes, so she got the answer and she said, my age is 2 times more than Ramesh's age. Yes, so she is again elder here and she compared the number. This is a new method or new way or another way which we are going to learn this year. Yes, my age is 2 times more than Ramesh's age. So here subtraction was done and here division is done. Here answer was 6 years and here it is 2 times. Yeah, so she said her age is 2 times more than Ramesh's age. Did you understand the two different ways to find out the answer, to compare the numbers? Yes. Now we will go to the next point. So we can also write Nilima's and Raj's ages are in proportion 2 colon 1. See, 2 upon 1 is written as 2 colon 1. This is in proportion. How to write 2 colon 1? Now how to read this? See how to read. We can read this as 2 is to 1. Yes, 2 colon 1 is read as 2 is to 1. Yes, now in mathematics, proportion of two numbers can be expressed as their ratio. So now let's see how to express proportion in ratio. See here. Proportion 2 is to 1 is written as 2 upon 1 in the form of a ratio. Understood how to write proportion in the form of ratio? 2 is to 1 is written as 2 upon 1. So now let's see more examples and understand about ratio and proportion. Now write down the name of the lesson, that is ratio and proportion, in your Math CW in algebra section, okay? And then you can write down the notes, whatever you are able to see on the screen. Yes, take a screenshot, you can zoom it little bit, and then you can write down the notes as I have written and shown on the screen. So write it in your CW in neat and good handwriting. Let us now study some of the examples of proportion in daily life which are given in our textbook. Okay, so the first example, Janki Amma's idlis and dosas are delicious. For idlis, she uses udad dal and rice in the proportion 1 cup dal and 2 cups of rice. But for dosas, the proportion is 1 cup dal and 3 cups of rice. That is, for idlis, the proportion of dal and rice is 1 is to 2, or the ratio is 1 upon 2. Whereas for dosas, the proportion is how much? Yes, 1 is to 3, or the ratio is 1 upon 3. Okay, so this is proportion and this is ratio. Yeah, so this example you can read and understand how the ratio and proportion is given. Next example, flowers were distributed among the girls in equal proportions. Fill in the empty boxes. So here the information about girls is given, that is number of girls, and here number of flowers. Okay, so the ratio is taken of girls upon flowers. So it is written as number of girls upon number of flowers, that is division. Okay, so in the first row you can see they have given number of girls is 3, that time the number of flowers were 12. So they have taken here 3 upon 12 is equals to, both are coming in 3's table, 3 ones are, so here 1, and 3 how much are? 4 are, so here 12. Yes, that is the answer is 1 upon 4. It means that every girl got 4 flowers. How many flowers? Every girl means one girl will get how many flowers? 4 flowers. Okay. The proportion of girls and flowers is 1 is to every 4. Okay. It is written as 1 is to 4, or the ratio is written as 1 upon 4. Now we have to find if girls are 5, how many flowers? Yes, for one girl how much we got? See, one girl is getting 4, isn't it? Then 5 girls how much? 5 into 4. Yes, so 5 fours are 20. So 5 girls when we are having, that time flowers how much we should have? 20. Okay, now see, next there are 32 flowers. Number of girls we don't know. Yes, here small number was given, we had to find the greater, we multiplied it. Now bigger is given, we have to find number of girls, we will divide. Yes, number of girls we have to find. So we'll divide by 4, is it? 34 divided by 4. Both will come in 4's table. 4 ones are, 4 we will take in mind, okay, because 32 and 4 are coming in 4's table. So 4's table we will keep in mind. 4, how much are 4? So 4 ones are 4, and 4 how much are 32? 4 8s are 32. So your answer will be 8. Did you understand? And one girl, how much flowers? Yes, we have already studied. One girl, that is 4 flowers. So we'll write here 4. So did you understand? Next example. Every student finds the ratio of his or her own age to that of his or her grandmother's. Okay? Johan's age is 10 years and his grandmother's 65. Okay? So both of their age is given. Johan said that the ratio was 10 upon 65 for him. Okay? Then 10 upon 65 means both of them will come in 5's table. We have learned test of divisibility, isn't it? At units place there is 0 and 5. Then these numbers come in 5's table. So when we divide by 5, our answer is 2 upon 13. Yes? We can make use of equivalent fractions to write the ratio in simplest form. Very, very important. See? This is the ratio, greater numbers. We brought it to 2 upon 13. Yes, means 10 upon 65. We divided and then brought it to 2 upon 13. Means the greater number did we bring to simplest form? And to bring it to simplest form, did we divide by same number? That is by making use of equivalent fractions. You have learned last year in fraction. How to convert to equivalent fraction. Yeah, means these two numbers, when we divide by same number, we get another fraction. Yeah, are you understanding what I am saying? 10 upon 65, we have divided by 5 and then we got answer 2 upon 13. That is the simplest form of 10 upon 65. Yes, so we have made use of equivalent fraction and got the simplest form and we have written the ratio. So equivalent fractions are used to write the ratio in simplest form. Now see the next example. Nikhil brought 12 guavas and 16 chikus. Now first in question in that, find the ratio of guava to chikus. Okay, so see ratio of guavas to chikku. Number of guavas upon number of chikkus. 12 upon 16. So 12 upon 16. Are they coming in 4's table? Both the numbers 12 and 16? Yes. So they divided both the numbers by 4. So 4 3's are 12. 4 4's are 16. So what is the simplest form? 3 upon 4. Equivalent fraction helped us, no? So the ratio is how much? Therefore, ratio of gavas to chikku is 3 upon 4. Did you understand? Now just see the next part of the question. Find the ratio of chikkus to gavas. Here what we did? Gavas to chikku. Now chikkus to gavas. So ratio of chikkus to gavas, number of chikkus upon number of gavas, 16 upon 12. Again both the numbers will come in 4's table. So 16 divided by 4 and 12 divided by 4 will give us 4 upon 3. Therefore, ratios of chikkus to gavas is 4 upon 3. Only the numerator and denominator has exchanged because ratios of gavas to chikku was there and then chikkus to gavas. Okay? So, did you understand how to find the ratio? So now we'll solve, try this from page number 57. In the figure, color some boxes with any color you like and leave some blank. Okay, we will do that. But before that, we'll read the first question. Count all the boxes and write the number. So count the boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 boxes. So use a pencil, okay, and write here. 16. Huh? Now we'll do coloring of the boxes. You can color any boxes with any color crayon. I am using and I am just drawing lines in the box which I want to color. So I have colored the boxes. Okay, and one more I'll color. Suppose this many boxes I have colored. I have just drawn the lines. You have to color it. Now, second question. Count the colored ones and write the numbers. Number. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 boxes I have colored. Okay. So, now I'll write number 6 here because I have colored 6 boxes. Okay, next. Count the blank ones and write the number. So, whichever are blank, count that and write the numbers. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, I'll write here number 10. Find the ratio of the colored to the blank. Means colored to the blank. That is 6 upon 10 ratio. Yes. See, I'll just write here 6 upon 10. Now, in which table are these two numbers coming? Yes, 2's table. So, I will divide both the numbers by 2. So, 2 3's are and 2 5's are. Now, 3 upon 5, will they come in any other table? No. So, the simplest form is 3 upon 5. Now, find the ratio of colored to the total boxes. See, now colored boxes are this. So, 6. Yeah. 2 total boxes. Total boxes are 16, isn't it? Yes. So, in which table are these two numbers coming? Again, they will come in 2's table. So, 2 3's are and 2 8's are 16. So, the ratio is what? 3 upon 8. Here, the ratio is 3 upon 5. Next, find the ratio of blank boxes to the total boxes. Blank, that is 10. Upon total, that is 16. So, these two numbers, again in which table will they come? 2's table. So, divide by 2. 2 5's are and 2 8's are 16. So, the ratio is 5 upon 8. Did you understand? Your answers will be different because you will color different number of box. But understood how to solve the questions? Now, let's learn some important points about ratio. So, here is one of the example in our textbook. The weight of the large block of jaggery is 1 kg. So, here it is that. This is a block of jaggery. What is its weight? 1 kg. And a smaller lump weighs 200 grams. So, this weighs 200 grams. Find the ratio of the weight of the lump of jaggery to that of the block. Okay, this upon this. So, here what they have written, see, weight of the lump upon weight of the block. Lump is 200 and weight of block is 1. So, is this correct, children? Is this right? Is the weight of lump 200 times that of block? No. So, what mistake have we made? Yes. First, we must measure both quantities in same unit. See, yeah? This is in kg and this is in gram. Then, can we compare? No, we cannot compare because their units are different. So, it would be convenient to use grams here. Yeah, so we will convert 1 kg to 1000 grams. Okay, therefore the block weighs 1000 gram and the lump weighs 200 grams. Okay, so weight of the lump upon weight of the block is equals to 200 upon 1000. So 2 into 100, 10 into 1000. So 100 will go. What will remain? 2 upon 10. So, they are 2 1s and 2 5s alike. Yes. So, 2 2 will get cancelled and what will remain? 1 upon 5. So, thus the ratio of the weight of the lump of jaggery to that of the block is 1 upon 5. Yes. So, children, now what we have learned? Yes, we have learned that When finding the ratio of two quantities of the same kind, their measures must be in the same units. Okay, so when the measures are in the same unit, we are able to find their ratio. Okay, now see the next thing, that is, a ratio can be used to write an equation. Then it is easier to solve the problem, they are saying. Now let's see how. Okay, so see, a hostel is to be built for school going girls. Two toilets are to be built for every 15 girls. Okay, means 15 girls, two toilets. If 75 girls will be living in the hostel, how many toilets will be required in this proportion? Okay, so see what we are going to do. Let us consider the proportion or ratio of toilets and girls. Okay, because both of them's information is given, isn't it? So we'll consider proportion or ratio of toilets and girls. So see, we know that two toilets are for 15 girls, but for 75 girls, how much toilets, we don't know. Yes, so let us suppose X toilets will be needed for 75 girls. Okay, so the ratio of the number of toilets to the number of girls is 2 toilets for 15 girls. So 2 upon 15. Okay, now let us write this in two ways and form an equation. So see, 75 girls, we don't know how much toilets, and we have taken it as X. So we are writing X upon 75. And this ratio we know, that is equals to 2 upon 15. Yes, now X value we have to find out. So there is 75 with X, and it is divided 75. Yes, so we will multiply 75 on both the side. Then this and this 75 goes, here it remains X. So 15, how much times will you take, then will you get 75? Yes, 15 should be 5 times. So 15 ones are 15 fives are. So we are, what is there? 2 into 5. If you will multiply 2 into 5, will give us 10. Therefore, 10 toilets will be required for 75 girls. Did you understand how to solve the problem? It's very easy. After this, we are going to solve the practice set. Okay.